It's Wednesday night. We've got a whole hour together, but somebody has to leave. Trust me, you are in for a shock, America. Your votes are in. The pressure is on. This is American Idol. Welcome. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. Welcome to American Idol. I'm Ryan Seacrest, and I'm definitely going to earn my money tonight as I host a results show stretched out further than Kirstie Alley's cycling shorts, ladies and gentlemen. That's the way it's going to be. Let's start with our introduction. Say hello to Randy, Paul, and Simon, our judges. Now, guys, who in this audience voted last night? Well, congratulate yourselves because you were part of over 34 million votes that came in for these people, your American Idol finalists. Let's hear it for them. What's up, gang? How you doing? It's Wednesday. I know we don't love Wednesdays over here, do we? Let's talk about last night for a second. Constantine, I know that you guys think about every move you make, if you will, during your performance. Last night, one move stuck out to many people, and that was the Constantine tongue move. just curious, what inspired that in your performance, Constantine?
I don't know. I really didn't think about it much. It just kind of happened. But I guess I was channeling some Kiss, you know,
energy. Little Gene Simmons?
I think so. Well, everyone good. Dig it? You guys like
good
it?
Good luck tonight. And Anthony, you must be feeling pretty good after last night.
Feels pretty good, yeah.
You okay?
Yeah, you know, I feel good.
You seem like you have to puke.
No, just a little nervous, that's all.
Okay, well, good luck tonight, Anthony. Now, the Vons, Von Zell. I know that, I know that you guys have been in the recording studio, which must be like a dream come true to finally be in the studio. What's it been like for you?
It's been awesome. Working with Desmond Childs has been a dream come true, so I've just been living it up, having a good time.
Working on that charity record, huh?
Yeah.
Let's show you guys how they chose that song. Take a look. As you know, our top 12 are releasing a single to benefit the American Red Cross. Over 3 weeks, the contestants have performed three different group songs. It's a long road. You voted online for your favorite, and the winner was When You Tell Me That You Love Me. We reunited the top 12 to record it at the Record Plant. Home of hits by Stevie Wonder, Barbra Streisand, Snoop Dogg, and the Rolling Stones. Running the board was star producer Desmond Child.
All right, here we go. You know, I'm in this awesome studio working with an awesome producer, songwriter, and life's good. It's all gravy from here on out.
Am I holding it too long?
It's just a little pitchy on the high note.
There's been a lot of pretty big records recorded in the studio. I wanna call the stars.
Down from the sky. When I look at a board like this, it just reminds me that I'm not an engineer. I like to be behind the microphone. I'm shining like a candle in the dark. It's good to know your place. Tell me that you
love me. Okay, let's do it one more time.
The acoustics are way better than the ones in my bathroom.
So cool.
It's something I always wanted, something I always dreamed of.
I mean, this is where the magic happens. It's fabulous.
This works the blender.
I just want to mess up all the buttons.
Hearing all of us together, it's a nice combination.
It's definitely going to be really, really great to be on something that everybody in the United States is gonna buy. Will you tell me that you love?
Fantastic. You were great.
Thank you.
So how did it turn out? Well, you can buy the single. Here it is right here. Coming up in stores April 19th. You can hear it live and newly arranged in a couple of minutes. The CD's got He Ain't Heavy, He's My Brother on there, plus Everything is Beautiful. So look for that. But don't get too cozy over there, you guys. One of you is headed home. Back with you live on Idol, and a lot of music coming your way tonight. In fact, the bottom three will each be singing the favorite song of the season. But now, as promised, time for the song you voted for, singing When You Tell Me That You Love Me. Here are your American Idol finalists.
Stars down from the sky.
Finalists. They make it look easy, but trust me, it is not. You have to live this stuff. You know what I mean? Eat it, breathe it, sleep it. Matter of fact, we trailed these contestants over the last few days. Take a look.
Living the life of an American Idol contestant is a lot tougher than it looks on TV.
On Thursdays, we pick our song, exactly what we're going to be doing for that following week.
Time to pick a song.
We listen to a bunch of different songs. Then we go through our faves with the vocal coach and the pianist.
But I actually really dig this Queen song, which is like the classic.
Once we get that song, we feel really good about it. We cut it up.
You have to do this part? I guess you
well, it's really difficult to, you know, cut it down to around a minute 30.
We got some work to do.
Fridays are more relaxing for me.
Here we go.
Producers interview us for the pre-song packages for the next show.
And when I was little, I would always get the words wrong.
See, it wasn't that bad, was it?
Not at all.
Then we get time to go shopping for our performance outfit.
It's kind of fun, you know, spending other people's money.
The show has a stylist, but it's completely up to us what we wear.
I have no sense of fashion. Sometimes I would actually wear my pajamas.
I'm a model,
you know what I mean?
And I do my little turn.
What's up? What do you think?
I think that's it for the shopping.
Saturday, we do some recording during the day.
Let me hear that.
That opening was fantastic.
We go to the Record Plant studio in Hollywood, where we're recording our album and the upcoming single. It's the only day when we do something that isn't directly related to the next show.
Okay, that's it. Let's switch to the other song.
It's pretty rare, but occasionally on Saturday, we get some time off.
Did everybody bring socks? Because those bowling shoes are gross.
But even when we do, it's organized, and we stay together as a group.
Yeah, baby.
I'm not going to lie to you, I didn't get a lot of strikes.
That is definitely right up my alley. Get it? Alley.
Action.
Sunday is a work day.
Action.
Ford is a big sponsor of American Idol, and every Sunday we record a promotional spot for Wednesday's show.
Coming through.
Here we go. And
it's a pretty exhausting day.
Running around. Cutting.
Got some new wheels. Check them out.
When I see the Ford moments every week, it makes it worth it. It's like, oh my God, I'm in a commercial.
Cut.
1-2, 1-2, check 1-2.
Monday is another long day. It's the first time we get to actually spend some time with the band.
And that sets everybody into mode of, all right, tomorrow is show day.
I want to start either right here with the big eagle behind me, or I want to start up there. I like this.
This is our day to make sure if there's any problems, we can work them out. We don't want to have to work them out tomorrow at 5 o'clock.
All right, it's Tuesday, show day. Get some butt this week.
Of course, Tuesday is when everything comes together. In the morning, we walk through the show for the cameras.
What was she doing? Was she walking down here?
We get one dress rehearsal.
Right, you gotta just do it like you're gonna do it for the real thing.
And then it's on to hair and makeup for the final touches.
You won't find me at home in my bath and putting foundation on my face.
There's never enough time on these days.
Let me tell you something. It's pretty nerve-wracking.
Have fun, everybody. 1, 2, 3.
We go on live at 5 p.m. in Hollywood. Seacrest out.
Well, it's Wednesday morning. It's the hurry up and wait to see who goes home day.
The worst day of the week is Wednesday, result day.
I hate Wednesdays.
Is the day everybody goes totally in a cocoon and just kind of says, all right, is it going to be me?
To wait around all day long to see who gets cut? That's not a good feeling.
Ladies, time to go to the studio.
Whoever it is, whether it's you or someone else, you will be saying bye to someone that day.
Someone's got to go.
And Wednesday is almost over. Our contestants, just a few hours ago, and they're even more nervous right now. No one, trust me, no one wants to go home, and you won't believe who is in our bottom three. Back live now on Actors Idol. It is the extended results special. Don't forget to check out the website after the show. Head to idolonfox.com and nominate your favorite video in the Ford Video Casting Call. You could win a brand new 2005 Ford Focus and a trip for two to the finale. Who's going to be in the finale? Let's hear it. Shout the names right now. Who's it going to be? All right. All that depends on the way you voted last night. Here's how they performed. Watch. Last night on Idol, the final eight took the stage to sing songs celebrating the year they were born. And in the judges' opinion, both Anwar and Anthony stepped up their game.
Every time you go away, you take a piece of me with you. I'm ever open again.
I think one of your better performances for a while, for sure.
Better from last week, and I'm proud of you.
Even though Nadia looked red hot, her song left the judges cold.
Wow, I don't even know what song that is.
I wanted to be in there with the song, and I felt
It was an appalling choice of song, and I think you could go home after that.
However, Von Zell's song choice was met with a different reaction.
You picked the right song.
Perfect song, huh?
Scott pleased Daryl Hall and John Oates when he performed their song. But he split the panel.
You did awesome, Scott!
You did awesome!
There were more bum notes than there were good notes. No, I'm being serious. So,
I'm up here and there's like millions of people at home who didn't have the nerve to do this, so
I think I'll rock.
Then, for the first time, Carrie really rocked.
I love the country girl, but I thought you rocked.
But Simon thought it was less than perfect.
But it was a little bit like watching a kitten who wants to be a tiger.
Finally, for our two oldest contestants, 1975 meant a rock anthem for Bo. And a Queen classic from Constantine. That left Simon with only one word.
Astonishing.
But who astounded you, America? The competition's eaten up.
Very good show. No doubt. Their best show yet. Let me ask you, Carrie. I know that you weren't feeling too well before last night's performance. What did you have? A little of the bug?
I don't know what it was. Allergies or what. But, you know, I gave it my all. I got out there and I really did. I was exhausted after I got off stage, so
How does that change, though, being a little sick, the ability to actually hit those notes?
It's just a lot. It takes a lot more to make sure that you hit them. And, you know, sometimes you do it, sometimes you don't. So, like I said,
did you guys tell if she was sick or not? I think you covered it up well. Good luck tonight. Nadia, no doubt a lot of pressure on this show.
Oh, yeah.
Each week that goes by, it gets tougher and tougher. Yeah. What are some of the tricks, some of the secrets in dealing with the pressure on Idol?
Well, there is definitely a lot of pressure with being on American Idol. I mean, your fellow contestants, the competition, the judges, and what they have to say. But when I first got into this competition, I pretty much said, I just want to do whatever God's will is for me. And at the end of the day, whatever that is, I'm happy to be here and I'm blessed and I deal with the pressure the best way I know how, and that's through prayer and just knowing that God has a plan for me.
And that gives you peace of mind and truth. And good luck tonight. Hey, Anwar, we got to chat about Anwar. You have some Anwar fans in here with us? You got them? Let's see those signs. It says, teachers love Anwar. You were very strong last night. What made the difference for you?
Well, you know, during the interim of this whole experience, I was like intellectualizing everything and just kind of overthinking it, I believe, and not letting myself, allowing myself to live the song. And now that I'm allowing myself to like become a part of the music and actually give myself permission to experience it and be elated about it, I think that makes a whole world of difference as opposed to just having it all up in here and not in here.
Do you actually, Anwar? Do you actually think about it when you're on this stage? Think about all the people that are watching right now when you're singing these songs?
No. I just sing, and I really, as much as I would love to touch the audience in the room, I gotta remember to touch the audience in the television as well. So it's a mix of both, but I don't think about all of that. I think about the message and just getting it across.
All right, Anwar. Good luck, my man. Well, as usual, I'm looking for the three people who got the lowest number of votes. But good news, each of you will sing a song in the bottom three. You get to pick a song, your favorite from this series so far. Cool? So, for example, Scott, favorite song of the series, what would it be?
I have two. Against All Odds and She's Gone. Now, that's not to say just because of what happened last night, but I, you know,
with Hall & Oates here in the house,
the feeling of the song and everything, I love the, you know, I love the feeling of the song, but it probably will be Against All Odds.
Against All Odds. I'm gonna ask you to perform that right now. Scott, you are in the bottom three tonight. Please come down, center of the stage, sing that song for us. All right, go get him now. Go get him, Scott. Is this his last song on the Idol stage? Soon we will know. He is in the bottom three. Scott Sable, everybody, take it away.
I wish I could just make you turn around. Turn around and see me cry. There's so much I need to say to you. So many reasons why. You're the only one who really knew me at all. So take a look at me now. Well, there's just an empty space. And there's nothing there.
The bottom three, but is he out of the show? The crowd in here loves him. What did you do? Stay with us to find out live. Back with you. It's American Idol live. Now, before the break, we heard from Scott Sable, who is the first we've announced in the bottom three tonight. Who is joining him? Dim the lights. Good luck. Here we go, guys. Starting with Kerry. You sang, Love is a Battlefield. Randy noticed you messed up some words, but overall, felt it was all right. Paula thought you rocked. Simon thought you were like a kitten trying to be a tiger. Kerry, America voted. You are safe. Congrats. Back again next week. All right, let's go to Anwar now. You sang, I'll Never Love This Way Again. Randy gave you props, thinks you are technically the best singer here. Paula thinks you are pleasing to the ear. Simon thought it was one of your better performances. America voted. Anwar, you are also safe. You can relax. All right, it's over to Bo. Bo Bice. Bo, you sang Freebird. You have a fan in Randy Jackson. He thinks you'd have a hit. Paula said, she will see you at the finale. But Simon thought with a song like that, you wouldn't get any votes. America voted. Bo, you are in the bottom three tonight. Hang on for one sec, Bo. Before you get up and sing, these are your votes at home. Let me ask you, I mean, you started this competition on top, rave reviews from the judges. What do you think has happened in the last week or two?
I think I've had a great time. That's what's happened, man. You know, this has all started as a bet between me and my mom, man. I mean, you know what I'm saying? What's the worst thing that's gonna happen to me? I go back home, I play gigs, and I have a blast doing what I've done my whole life, man. I'm not worried about it, dude. It's good.
What's on the line with this bet?
Pardon?
What's on the line with this bet that you have between you and your mom?
I don't know who's even in the lead with the bet. You know, if she won or I did. You know, she just bet that I wouldn't go try out, and I bet she wouldn't go sleep on the floor of the convention center for 3 days with me. So,
there's some love, Jackson. Let me ask you a question. You've loved Bo. I mean, you really have. If you generalize his performances, you thought he's done pretty well. No, what do you think's happened to him in the last couple of weeks, though?
I think Bo's the bomb, man. I think he's probably lost a little confidence the last couple of weeks. Hasn't been his stellar weeks, but I still think he's the bomb, dude.
A lot of people surprised to hear, honestly, tonight. I was surprised when I found out that you are in the bottom three ball. Paula, you said you're going to see him at the finale. What happened?
I have no worries in the world. Trust me, you will see him in the final.
But, Bo, you could be out tonight.
Good, brother.
Before those final results, let's have you up here on this stage
let's
one more time.
It.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome. Singing for you live. Bo Bice, take it away, man.
So baby, when did you sit still? Now who killed that bird upon your windowsill? Now aren't you the reason that it broke its back? Now tell me, did I see you, baby, laugh about that? If I could
there he is, Bo Bice, with his favorite, Remedy, the Black Crowes. Is he in or is he out? We're looking for one more in the bottom three, live after the break. Hang on. Back with you, it's American Idol Live. Take a look. Bo has joined Scott in the bottom three. These are your results. One more space to go. Let's get to it right now. Starting with Constantine. You sang Bohemian Rhapsody. Randy thought your showmanship was worthy of a 10. Paula thinks you are the one to beat. Simon said it was astonishing. Before I tell you what America did here, let me ask you quickly, Simon, what did you mean by great. Astonishing? Good or bad?
Well, you know, everything about it was astonishing. I mean, you know, taking on a song like that is incredibly risky. I mean, it really is one of those songs you normally don't touch. And if I'd have known in advance you were going to record that or sing that song, I would have probably said I wouldn't try that. And everything from the performance through the tongue, everything about it was astonishing. But what was more astonishing was it worked. It was good.
You know, when I watched it back, I thought maybe he was being sarcastic, so we wanted to clear that up.
You never know with Simon, but I'm thankful for his comments, so I appreciate it.
Well, especially when he says that.
Yeah, that was really, really unbelievable. Honestly.
Constantine, a shocking night tonight.
Yes, it is, Ryan. It's been a very shocking night.
America but, voted. It worked for them. You're safe. All right. Von Zell. You ready? You sang Let's Hear It for the Boy. Randy felt it was another great performance from you. Paula adored you and your vocals, saying you picked the right song. Simon felt that you won fans with that performance. You made people want to vote. Now, if you are in the bottom three tonight, what song will you sing?
I Have Nothing by Whitney Houston.
Okay. Take a look, guys. You got Von Zell, Anthony, Nadia. One of them is in the bottom three. One of them could be leaving us. Let's go to Anthony. You sang Every Time You Go Away. Randy said he was surprised with your comeback. Paula was very proud of you, and even Simon was on your side. He said it was very good. If you're in the bottom three tonight, Anthony, what will you sing?
I'm going to sing the same thing I sang last night, which is Every Time You Go Away.
That's your pick. That's your favorite of the series. Nadia, what song are you going to sing? You are in the bottom three tonight. What's your pick?
You Don't Have to Say You Love Me by Dusty Springfield.
Let me help you out here, darling. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Nadia. Could be your last time on the stage.
When I said I needed you, you said you would always say it wasn't me.
Well done. Watch yourself on that grate with the heels. Gentlemen, come on in. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, definitely some surprises on this stage. This is your bottom three. Scott, Bo, and Nadia. I hear boos. Two are safe. One is out. I'll tell you who goes where after this break. Hang on. Welcome back to American Idol Live, the moment we've been building up to. Take a look. Scott, Bo, and Nadia in the bottom three. You can't complain if you don't vote. You have to vote. Randy Jackson, let's go to you for a second. Advice for people watching at this stage. This is the final phase. We're gearing up for the big finale. What should people be looking for each and every week?
Listen, I mean, you know, it's about consistency. I say that all the time. You know, you got to be great every time you hit the stage. Whether you're on Idol or just performing on your own after, before this, whatever. The thing is, though, is that, you know, it comes to mind to me that I think it was Ruben Studdard who once stood on that very stage and Fantasia who were in the bottom three and they went on to win. So build up your confidence, go out there. You got to want this. You got to want it. You got to give it up every night.
Paula, your thoughts on that?
Well, we have all seen crazy things happen here, and we've seen the greatest of great performers be in the bottom three, so that's one thing. Having said that, you know, you always got to remember the passion and why you came here in the first place and what you possess inside. It's a gift that you have. You've got to always remember that and come out there and perform like it's the last time you're performing.
Cal, at this stage, picking the right song, more important than ever?
100%. Exactly the same in the real world. Nadia, if you had sung that song last night, you would not be standing there now. You wouldn't. And you know something else? You know, when we criticize people, you know, I know more than you guys because I've been doing this for 30 years. So, you know, watch back the performance. And understand why you're there. And often it's because...
Ryan!
It's true!
Ryan, the head is lodging! The
ego is bigger than her hair.
Oh, my God!
Do you regret that choice?
As far as what?
Song.
I actually don't. In all honesty, because as I said, from day one, I know I picked the little songs that were a little offbeat to some and that were a little unfamiliar, but it was things that I felt my fans and, you know, people at home really loved about me. And unfortunately, maybe that's just not working anymore.
A candid response. We're about to find out right now. Let me do something good, something nice for one of you. Bo, Nadia, step back for me. Let Scott through in front of you. You are safe, Scott Sable.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Congratulations, Scotty.
Yeah!
Praise God.
Blessed.
Step right up. Now down to Nadia and Bo. One of them leaving us tonight in just a second. Is this all wrong, Jackson? I'm watching you shake your head right now with this look of disgust.
I just think that you hit it on the head, Ryan. If you really believe that these two shouldn't be there, you gotta vote. And I also think there's a little confusion going on, but as I said, stood right there in those spots were two former winners, Fantasia and Ruben. So, hey, come on, come on. Believe Paula, in yourself.
You said that Bo's gonna be in the finale. You still believe that he's gonna make it in the next 30 seconds?
Bo, I'm gonna ask you a question. Do you believe you've got what it takes?
I know I've got what it takes to do what I do, because I do
then
it every day.
You're gonna have to show that on that stage, eat this, all right? I believe in you, and everybody out here believes in you.
All right, guys, let me step between you and deliver the results. After the nationwide vote, America, you've decided that Bo, you are safe. You may have a seat. That means Nadia leaves us tonight on American Idol. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Nadia Turner. You may say something, absolutely.
I just want to say thank you to everyone at home in Miami that supported me, my family, my fans. This has been an incredible journey. I mean, beyond anything anyone could comprehend.
We do love you, Nadia. You're going to be fine. You're going to be fantastic. Take a look at that journey right now on American Idol. Watch this tape, sweetheart.
The whole American Idol experience has been just incredible.
Unanimous yes, I say yes. Welcome to Hollywood, Nadia Turner!
Well, I think it's affected me emotionally in a positive way.
You are the antidote to karaoke hell.
I'd want to be remembered that I kept it real the whole time. Like, no matter what I said, no matter what the song choice was, that I don't leave here having any regrets and knowing that at the end of the day, Nadia was Nadia and I stayed true to myself.
You definitely got the star potential going on.
Every song I've ever sang on this show has some trial and tribulation or just positivity in my life.
I'm so proud of you, Nadia. Way to go.
In a competition full of hamburgers, you are a steak.
I sing with passion, and that's what I will always do.
There she is, ladies and gentlemen, Nadia Turner. Thank you so much.
Thank you, American Idol, for this opportunity, and the journey has just begun. So watch out, baby. Hoo, hoo,
hoo, hoo. Best of luck. And our journey continues. We're back again live on Tuesday, 8, 7 Central. Seven singers, they battle it out. It's Idol. Local news is next. Seacrest out.